All night, I've been highlighting the sectors that have suddenly become a lot more attractive thanks to the rapid decline in interest rates. With the 10-year 2.5%, income-seeking investors are much more willing to just buy a dividend stock, and I don't blame them. You know what? That includes the utilities, another slow and steady group with juicy dividends. Take Dominion Energy, long one of my favorites, the huge utility with some major natural gas production and transmission assets, including a liquefied natural gas terminal in Maryland. It represents one of the few ways to export this cheap, plentiful fuel overseas. Now, Dominion stock has moved up nicely over the last few months, and even here still it sports a notoriously BIG yield of 4.8%. Plus, unlike the rest of the utilities, this one actually has a catalyst. See, in January, Dominion closed on its acquisition of SCANA, the troubled South Carolina-based utility, which is now in the process of integrating. Can that give us more upside here? Let's take a closer look with Tom Farrell. He's the chairman, president, and CEO of Dominion Energy. Get a better sense about the company's doing and where it's headed. Now that the SCANA deal is complete, Mr. Farrell, welcome back to Mad Money.
Great to be with you, Jim.
All right, so Tom, I'm reading the local papers in South Carolina. They tell me April 15th, get ready. You're going to be running. You're going to see a lot of trucks. You're going to see a lot of activity from Dominion. How do you expect it to go?
Should go really well. We closed on the transaction actually on January 1st, and what's happening in a couple of weeks is the name change. In South Carolina, we'll eliminate the old names, the old South Carolina utility, and everybody will see Dominion Energy trucks and hat, you know, hard hats and shirts, et cetera.
Do you think people even know? I mean, I know that the legislature made you give people a rate cut, but I was just trying to figure, I mean, does the average person understand that their big energy company got in trouble over a nuclear power plant, fell on hard times, and got acquired by a company that, frankly, I think was always better run?
Well, I think the public there is well aware of what happened. There's lots of publicity around the Summer. The name of the plant they were expanding is called Summer, the nuclear plant. And it was well covered in the press throughout the state. So I think they're pretty well aware of what happened. It was a year-long process with the legislature first and the regulators at the end. But I think it came out to a place that was fair for everybody, fair for our shareholders and their customers in South Carolina.
You know, sometimes I can't understand. I think you're one of the least controversial companies on earth, but a lot of people are worried about the expansion. I'm looking at a Barclays piece. This is from just a couple days ago, and it says, dividend cut debate is put to rest. Tom, was there ever really a debate about your dividend?
Certainly not with us. Never been discussed. This year we increased our dividend 10%. We're looking at slowing the rate of growth on the dividend starting next year. But there's never been any discussion with anybody that I know of about cutting the dividend. It's just there'd be no reason whatsoever to do that.
Okay, let's talk about some of the things you've got going that are pretty amazing. And I think somewhat controversial and polarizing. I don't think they should be, but I'm old-fashioned. Atlantic Coast Pipeline is a gigantic way for the Northeast to get off of hooked on imported oil, of all things, the worst fuel, and yet somehow this is a very controversial project. Could you explain to our viewers in big terms the pros and the cons and why you think the pros outweigh the cons?
Well, what we're talking about is a 600-mile pipeline, Atlantic Coast Pipeline, that we are about 50-50 partnership with another utility, Duke Energy, out of North Carolina. Its sole purpose is to bring natural gas to end-use customers, utility customers in Virginia and North Carolina. We don't have enough pipeline capacity in the state of Virginia to serve our customers in the southeast part of the state. And Duke Energy wants to use the gas from the power plant, the gas from the pipeline, to close coal plants to replace them with gas-fired power plants, which are much cleaner. The controversy is really only with a small group of people, environmental community. They're very exercised about it. I understand that. But the vast majority of Virginians are in favor of the pipeline, as they are in North Carolina. We've had fits and starts with it, but I have high confidence it'll be completed.
Okay, that's important because you just made final decision to close 10 coal and old gas-fired units. Your utility has stated that you don't want to be on coal. You do a pipeline, you get off coal, the environment's cleaner. These are decisions that you're made out of concerns about the environment, correct?
Yeah, Jim, when I started at Dominion, it's about two decades ago, we were about 55% of our power production came from coal. Last year, it was 12%.
Right.
And that's been largely replaced with renewables and natural gas.
All right, so let's talk about liquefied natural gas. We often hear the president says, you know what, this could be a great chip for the Chinese want to buy our natural gas. Please tell the truth. You are sold out, and so is Cheniere. They can't make any more deals with the Chinese, correct?
We certainly can't. I'm not sure about Cheniere, but we're sold out for 20 years to the Japanese and Indians.
20 years you're sold out. Well, I think that interests that
years.
One more thing. You chose just a few days ago to have a sustainability, environmental, based, and social government governing day. Why did you do that?
You know, we actually were the first company. We're pretty sure any public company in the United States to hold a
you
session
are.
Like that.
You are.
We have a wonderful story to tell, and we want to make sure people can hear it. We've cut our carbon emissions at Dominion by 50%, which is twice the average of our utility peers in the United States. We have a large gas pipeline system. We're cutting the methane emissions from that by 50% between now and 2030. We're going to cut the carbon emissions out of our fleet by 80% by 2050. Fantastic story to tell. Lots of philanthropy, about a third of $1 billion of philanthropy in just the last decade. So we have a lot of people are interested in those topics, and we wanted to make sure we got out the facts instead of what people say about us, which are often not based in the truth.
Right. Now, I know I'm getting away, but I do want to point out that you also talked about diversity. You talked about pay. These are issues that you brought up that you felt was important for the people, right?
Yeah, we're actively recruiting people to our board and all of our ranks from all different walks of life. We've got all sorts of awards for best for diversity, best for women, women's choice awards, transparency in our political giving awards. We're trendsetters there. We're in the top quartile of the Just Capital rankings on social responsibility. We have a very good story to tell, and we just need to do a better job of telling
it. Well, I'm glad you told it. I want to thank Tom Farrell. He's the chairman, president, and CEO of Dominion Energy, 4.8% yielder, safe dividend. You heard that. Going to go up over time. And a person who takes all of these issues about the environment very, 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 they're very important. Why don't other companies do what he did? Why don't the other 499 companies in the S&P 500 have a day like he just did? Mad Money's back after the break. Booyah! Jim Cramer here from Mad Money. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube. Click here to subscribe and get the jump on my exclusives with CEOs, plus market news, investing advice, and a whole lot more.